Welcome again. In the last units, we got to know all point symmetry elements and operations. This was not only for the fun of it, but because we want to be able to classify the outer shapes of crystals according to their symmetry. The interesting thing, I think I mentioned that earlier, is that all imaginable crystals of the world can be classified into only 32 principally different classes. This means, whatever the concrete external shape of a crystal might be, according to the symmetry properties, only 32 different forms exist. The deeper reason for that circumstance is that crystals have not only point symmetry, but translational symmetry as well, and that both these symmetries cannot be combined arbitrarily. We already know, for instance, that it is impossible to combine fivefold rotational point symmetry with a repeating lattice. This is different for everyday objects. These objects can have, in principle, any conceivable symmetry. Remember, for instance, this wine glass with its infinite rotational symmetry. However, it is also true that a tiling made of identical tiles with fivefold rotational does not exist. Okay, but now let's move on how to classify crystals into classes. There is a simple recipe for that task. First, we have to examine the outer shape of a crystal and have to determine all symmetry elements which can be found in this specific crystal. Second, we write down all unique symmetry elements. These are all symmetry elements which constitute a symmetry element of their own, meaning they were not generated by other symmetry elements. Third, every crystal that have the same symmetry elements which we just have determined belong to the same crystal class. Fourth, you will see that these crystal classes can be further categorized according to the crystal system. Okay, let's practice this together. Look at this drawn blue shape of a crystal. What kind of symmetry elements are you able to discover? Think for a while, stop the video if you want, and write down those you can see. Okay, there's obviously no mirror plane. There's also no rotational symmetry, but there is a center of inversion. This is the only symmetry element in this case. And a center of inversion is denoted in crystallography as 1 bar. And this is also the crystal class of this schematically drawn crystal. Every crystal class has also a specific name, which is derived from a geometrical description of the most representative shape of such crystals. So, the crystal class 1 bar is also called pinacoidal. Not very many crystals in nature belong to this crystal class, but amongst others, for instance, plagioclase, microcline, turquoise, and wollastonite. Let's examine a second example. Here you see another schematic drawing of a crystal shape. Are you able to identify the symmetry elements of this shape? Well, there's one mirror plane, shown here in red, which cuts the shape into two identical halves. And there is a twofold axis of rotation perpendicular to that mirror plane. This is shown again here on the right, at a different viewing angle. At this URL, you can also see a rotatable three-dimensional model of this shape, where you can get an even better impression of the shape. The crystallographic notation is 2 over m. Generally, for one specific viewing direction, rotational symmetry is denoted first, then mirror symmetry follows. And this bar is the respective expression for the circumstance that the rotational axis is running perpendicular to the mirror plane. Or to express this again more mathematically, the surface normal of the mirror plane and the axis of rotation are parallel. They run along the same direction. This is the reason why we write this not in a consecutive manner, but in the same column, so to say, same viewing direction. If you want to save space and if you write this symbol in a continuous text, then you can also write this in that way, 2/m. Okay, are there any other symmetry elements? Did we forget something? Well, there is indeed another symmetry element, namely a center of inversion. However, this center of inversion does not have to be mentioned explicitly because it is automatically generated by the other two symmetry elements. This means we only write down the unique symmetry elements, only the symmetry elements which are not generated by the presence of other symmetry elements. 2 over m is another crystal class, and this class is also called prismatic. Gypsum, which is calcium sulfide dihydrate, for instance, belongs to this crystal class. Here a beautiful, very clear sample of gypsum with this typical prismatic shape is shown. Other crystals, which belong to the same crystal class, and this means simply that their outer shapes have the same symmetry properties, are azurite, chlorite, clinopyroxene, epidote, malachite, kaolinite, orthoclase, talc, and vivianite, a hydrated form of iron 2-phosphate, also known as blue iron ore, a mineral which is relatively popular with mineral collectors. Okay, in the next unit, we will have a look at a slightly more symmetric crystal shape, a shape in which symmetry elements are present not in only one viewing direction. See you soon again!